The following show contains adult content. It's not our intent to offend anyone, but we want to inform you that if you are a child under the age of 18 or get offended easily, this next show may not be for you. The content, opinions, and subject matter of these shows are solely the choice of your show hosts and their guests, and not those of the Entertainment Network or any affiliated stations. Any comments or inquiries should be directed to those show hosts. Thank you for listening.
Get your tickets!
Oh, seriously, come on. Yes, you are. You're going to take it until you realize you've been taking it all this time, and then you're going to get frustrated with it, and you're going to stop taking it. Please have your tickets in hand and gather your belongings. You are now boarding the Crazy Train! This is In Your Face. I'm your hostess with the mostest, Tix's very own little darling, the female mouth of the South, Rebel Meddler. Thanks for boarding the train at stations W4CY, W4VET, K4HD, and all of our affiliated stations. Take seats, people. We are starting our journey. This is an interactive ride, so feel free to join the chat room. Hello, chat room. I forgot where I was. Oh, anyway. We also offer you en route entertainment, and today we have new videos for you. What? That's right. We are premiering a new video on the ITB today, so check it out. We also allow you to check out that same video on my YouTube channel. Make sure to subscribe to the damn YouTube channel, people, please. Please. I am, as you see, I put up a new video. You'll get there. We'll get there. It's all good. That's not what I want. See, I was talking about YouTube and I clicked the YouTube button. That's not what I wanted. I wanted this. Oh, multitasking. What did I say about doing that? I said stop doing it. Anyway, hell, if that ain't enough for you, you can call or Skype into the station. The call-in number is 561-623-9429. What was that again? Turn your hearing up. Hearing aid up, baby. 561-623-9429. On Skype, look for W4CY Radio. You can voice your opinion, speak your mind, put information out there, or just call in to talk. I like to shoot the shit, and I welcome controversy. Brit! If you got the stones, that is. God, goddess, family, friends, and everyone listening, please forgive me for anything and everything that's about to come out of my mouth. I say this before the show because, quite frankly, I can be a bitch.
Don't fuck with me, fellas! This ain't my first time at the rodeo.
Well, people, we all know it. Sure the hell ain't my first time at the rodeo. Come on, man. Neither kind. Neither kind. Anyway, it's all good. It's all good. I speak my mind, and what I say is of my opinion, my own opinion at the time I say it. So, therefore, deal with it. Oh, yeah. So, the video. Yes, we put up a new video. It's been, now it's the time for me to check YouTube. It's been 9 months, I think, since we put up a new, no. It's an original video. No, I did put up a show video. I have put up lots of show videos. They just keep taking them down because of copyright issues. But they did allow some to go up. They allowed, let me see, let's go to videos. About a month ago, I got one of the show videos to stay up. So we got that. And then 9 months ago, I put up some Marvel Universe stuff. And then prior to that, it was a year. And then, let's see. Yeah, it's been a while since I've put up stuff. A year, 2 years, 3 years. Oh, police are coming. No, not for me, not this time. 4 years, 5 years, 6 years. Damn, 6 years is a long time ago to be on YouTube, and still going back further, back further, back further, back further. Most of them got put up at 6. Oh, 7 years ago. Wow. I think I loaded my first video to my YouTube channel 7 years ago, is what it seems like. Anyway, so yes, indeed. Go to my YouTube channel and subscribe to the videos. The reason I'm doing this, why am I doing this? Because I am trying to get to a certain number of subscribers. Okay? Just help a girl out, why don't you? You can actually do stuff more when you get so many subscribers, also so many likes on your videos. So hey, click the like button. I'd do it back for you. Absolutely. If you guys asked me to, I would click your like buttons and subscribe to your channels for you. I feel the love. Feel the love. Feel the love. I'm looking through some of the videos. It's wow, it's been real. And only 2 of my show videos have been allowed up so far. This sucks. I really, really wish it was, they'd let some of the other ones go by. I'd have to figure out, maybe if I get more subscribers and listeners and likes on my videos, they'll let the show videos stay up. Chad works so hard on them, and I thank him so much. He is awesome. Absolutely. That's the worst thing about putting videos on YouTube, if they'll give the thumbs up on. Yeah, I know. I mean, I'm doing it for a reason. There's method to the madness, people. Absolute method to my madness is always method to the madness, right? Yeah, you just have to figure it out. Anyway, so what you're seeing on the ITV, if you're watching ITV, you're seeing the eclipse from 8/21/2017. I finally got one of the videos up. You know those commercials? I'm sure you've all seen them on TV. The little things, the little pictures stuck on the SD cards, and they're stuck on the phones, and they're stuck in the cameras and all of that. That's me. Yes, I was the inspiration for those commercials. I'm so sad. Yes. So sad indeed. I'm working on it. Look, we talked about that. We talked about finding downtime so I can do any of the stuff that I need to get done. I'm working on it. Hey, I finally got one video loaded up, and it's new, and it's stuck. This one had no choice really but to stick, because there's really nothing possibly to copyright in this video. You know, I should copyright the damn eclipse or something. I don't know. You can't do that. I mean, it's so wrong. But it's possible. Anything's possible. You never know what people are. Crazy people nowadays. It happens. It absolutely positively happens. And you got to figure it out. Speaking of figuring it out, you got to figure out time. You've got to figure out things. You got to figure out what's going to work for you. Oh, man. You never really know. Never really know. Is this the button I click? No, that's not the button I click. I need to click this button. Maybe. And you click on your channel and you go to Creator Studios. And, oh man, we are only to 8,966 views. I need to get that to 10,000. Just like I need to get my subscribers to 10,000. Why? Because I have to. Oh, man. But I do. I might be wrong on the numbers, but I'm fairly certain. I need 10,000 subscribers, and I need my videos to be up to 10,000 views. And my videos are 8,966. It doesn't take long, people. Just click on them. Scroll through the video. Hit the like button. You know, whatever works for you. You got to do what you got to do. I'm not trying to beg here. I am, actually, but, you know, it's all good. Don't worry. Also subscribe to Rational Minds 78. Irish Ginger has a YouTube channel as well. Subscribe to hers. Let me know what it is, Irish, and I will put it up there. Am I sure about what? Wait, let me see. I don't know. I'm fairly certain. I definitely will like you back if you subscribe to my channel. I will subscribe, and I'm not afraid to just go through and click like on the videos. I have no problem with that. Where's the time, right? Well, it's easier said than done. You could actually open it up in a separate, window and just make sure the volume is on mute, Just let them play and then hit like. It doesn't take much. You don't even have to put any effort into it. I need to get my views to 10,000 views. There's certain levels that you can't reach until, or certain things on YouTube that you can't do until you reach certain levels. So I need to reach that 10,000 views, and I'm hoping to get the subscribers. The subscribers, I need those too. So help me out, people. Tell your friends. I'm asking. I'm asking indeed. Anyway, so where am I? We are. Has it gotten dark yet on the video? No, it hasn't. I don't think. It might have. I wasn't watching. Darn. I think I was messing with the camera then. Anyway, I should be watching. And no, I didn't turn the camera sideways. This is being taken from a phone. And, no, it's not edited. It is in the process. It's starting to get dark now in the video. So hopefully you're watching. This is the eclipse. This is the 2017 August 21st eclipse. No, this is actually happening. This is on the camera. No, it's actually on the phone. And I know I didn't turn it sideways because it only stabilized in this direction. Look how dark it got. I mean, this is actual happening in this video. It was amazing. It was a total eclipse in where we were. It does totally go dark. No editing, no anything. This is real time. This is real life video. Okay? Totally happening right there live for you. Well, it was live at the time. Okay. But anyway, the total eclipse. In this area, we were in Tennessee. It was a great time. It was a great time, and it was fun. Okay? I made it happen. I decided that that is something I was going to do, and I made it happen. We don't always make things happen because we're too busy making things happen for other people, but it was nice. It was fun to go there. I do believe. This is a stationary camera. I know it's moving around. It's moving around because it's sitting on something that's bouncing. We're on a mountain here, people. Where was I going with this? Oh, anyway. So I also had y'all on Facebook Live. So if you were live on Facebook with me, you saw it happen right there as well. And you'll see the nighttime lights are coming on. Solar lights or whatever. It's really, really awesome. Of course, people have to drive with their lights on. This is the middle of the day when this happened. Y'all knew about the eclipse. It was fun. Anyway, speaking of making things happen, I want to reach this goal. I need to get the videos watched. Nope, see, here it comes. Here it comes. The sun is uncovering. Now, that's a potent thing, okay? The sun can go totally black and darken everything, nighttime sky, and then poof, there it is, coming right back. It's very nice to actually sit there and watch. And unfortunately, it's such a quick thing, but it was an amazing experience. So I hope you all enjoyed experiencing this with me, and I hope you guys, and if you missed it, no worries, we will be playing the video more, and you can also go to my YouTube channel. And like the video, watch the video, like the video, do what you got to do. It's all good. Anyway, you can remember to like and subscribe to Irish Ginger's channel. That's youtube.com/user/Irish Ginger. Also remember to go to Rational Minds 78. And of course, my YouTube channel, youtube.com/user/Rebel Meddler. Yes, indeed. Subscribe, people. Subscribe. You never know what I'm going to throw up there. anyway, so speaking of, I also give you guys opportunities to do things during the show. Now, you know, you're always welcome to pick a song for the show for us to play, and Irish has done that. Irish picked another song this week. Oh my Lord, am I gonna murder some names here? I should have practiced this. Rasmussen? Higher Ground. I hope I didn't murder it, but There you go. This is Higher Ground. We'll be right back.
Ships in the making, bound for a distant shore, world for the taking, men gone forevermore, boarding and setting sail, yet victory won't prevail. Arrow in the air, make your mark and leave it hanging there. Be the first to turn around, take the leap to land on higher ground. Ships in the making, bound for a distant shore. World for the taking, men gone forevermore, boarding and setting sail, yet victory won't prevail. Oh, free the arrow in the air, make your mark and leave it hanging there.
Concert of the year, and it's coming June 16th. Lamar Dixon Expo Center welcomes the second annual Rock in the Bayou Concert and Car Show, starring Starship. Plus, the voice of Foreigner, Lou Gramm. Tickets $30 advance or $45 at the door and going fast at etix.com. You'll also see Matthew and Gunnar Nelson, and the world-famous Molly Ringwald. Plus, the Artemis Pyle Band honoring the music of Ronnie Van Zant's Lynyrd Skynyrd. Also, the Nelson Blanchard Band, Remedy, and more. The second annual Rock in the Bayou Concert and Car Show. Get your tickets now at etix.com. Like us on Facebook, a Scott Ennis production.
Production, absolutely. A Scott Ennis production, and we will be giving away tickets right here for those who are going to be in the area to go to the show. Alrighty, so, alright, Now is the time that I tell you, if there's children watching this show, if you're watching ITV, take them away because I'm about to blow your mind. I could not believe that this, I really couldn't believe that this was out there. I was somebody went to see the new Deadpool 2 movie, and in the previews, they showed a new, what was perceived to be a new Muppets movie. This is not a children's Muppet movie, okay? No, no. Please, if you have children watching the ITV right now, I implore you, please, do not let them watch what I'm about to show you. It will scar you for life. It did me. Anyway.
Hold on. If you haven't seen the new Deadpool movie, you need to. It is the best Deadpool movie ever. I mean, I know there's only two, but I don't know how they're going to top this one.
I have not seen Deadpool 2 yet.
I had sent
someone to watch it and give me their reviews. But what I got back from that review was this. Did you see the previews that they had?
Yes, and I'm excited. And by the way, I think we need to get Marvel to make a Peter movie. Peter is in Deadpool. You'll understand. Peter just wanted to answer an ad. Hashtag Peter needs his own movie.
Peter needs his own movie. Well, I will probably go see Deadpool, so we'll see, to give my own critique on this.
I dressed up and everything for Deadpool. My bro dressed up like Deadpool. I was his unicorn, and my friend was Gwenpool, which if you're a comic book nerd, you know who she is.
I do not know. I think I'm more of a DC comic. Who I know some, like I know Batman and Superman and Aquaman and the Justice League. I think those are DC comics, not Marvel.
Yes, they're DC.
I'm X-Men, a DC comic gal.
X-Men, Avengers, they're all Marvel.
I mean, Gambit and I are married, so yes, I know. I'm one of those multiple marriage things because I'm also married to Kaiba. So, but Gambit and I have had a long going relationship. So, I do know the X-Men, of course, mm-hmm. but I didn't really follow Marvel, I guess. I don't know. I'll have to work on that. But speaking of working on, again, I want to implore you, if you have children watching the ITV, turn their heads away because I'm about to rock your little worlds, and I'm not one to want to disturb children. Okay? During the previews for Deadpool, they had this. It's the Happy Time Murders. Okay? I'm going to warn you once again. Ladies and gentlemen, what we are about to play for you is disturbing, and you will never look at Muppets the same way again. All right, Captain Nestor, if you could please gear up that video. This is the Happy Time Murders. We're going to play the video and its audio, so you guys can see for yourselves.
I love singing and dancing. Hiya, folks.
$0.50, I'll suck your dick.
Well, it's a great price. It almost makes me wish I had a dick for you to suck.
Oh, I'll take that as a yes.
You two are the most decorated offices in this department. What do you see?
Looks like a robbery gone wrong to me.
This wasn't a robbery, this was a hit.
Welcome!
Someone out there is killing puppets.
Hey, handsome.
You looking for some rotten cotton?
I'm a woman.
That's okay.
Yeah, that's even better.
Got a good time for you.
We're gonna catch the bastards who did these murders.
Because bodies are gonna start piling up.
You're one of the best damn cops I've ever seen.
I'll have your badge for this. I'm in the fucking FBI.
Oh yeah, what's that stand for? Fucking big idiot?
Cop, good cop, where is your dignity? Where's your empathy? Where is your sympathy? Bad cop.
You think
gets crazy, I'm gonna go crazy as shit.
Is that just a fantasy?
Yo! God, are you all right?
I ruptured my hymen.
This pure ecstasy.
I'm not doing this.
Do it.
Oh, sorry about your dead human friend, Phillips.
That is good shit.
Well, fuck me.
Maybe.
Is Phil in?
He's servicing a client.
Is that what I think it is?
Here I go.
Yes, it was. That disturbing. I'm sorry. I just can't. I don't even know. I'm going to see this movie, The Happy Time Murders. Yes, I am. Why? Because. I never knew puppets could do that. Wow. That was, yeah, a lot of silly string. Oh, my word. I never expected anything like that to ever come about. I mean, this ain't Kermit and Piggy and Scooter and Gonzo. Oh, no. Now, it seems like they do resemble a little bit of the creature features that you might have seen in some of the Muppet movies, or maybe on Sesame Street. It even mentions it earlier in the preview. But yeah, holy crap. Yes, indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, they went there. And I'm going to go there. I'm going to go see the movie only because the Happy Time Murders. You know, that gives a whole new twist. Now, what was it with Roger Rabbit? Who Framed Roger Rabbit? And Jessica Rabbit. And they had some pretty off things in there. But this one's really going to take the cake. And to be quite honest, this is just showing where we have taken a decline back to what seems like Sodom and Gomorrah. I cannot believe they have corrupted things. What if that gets out? Somebody's going to think, I mean, first of all, it says Happy Time Murder, so I don't think a child should go to this. But what if it gets out? You know, people are going to be doing those stupid things where they videotape stuff in the movies. And I mean, where you can't play this on TV. Okay, I know they're going to have to form a support group. Okay. So, no, do I support corruption? No, I don't. I really don't. I don't understand. This should be something that is only, I mean, there might have been kids that went to Deadpool. I don't know. Deadpool might be an R-rated movie, so you still have to be of a certain age to get in there. But, wow. I just don't understand what happened. Ted. Yeah, Ted was. I don't think Ted was this bad. I don't know. I didn't see Ted for years after it came out. So I did see parts of Ted. It's pretty. But I was not expecting. Because when they said, oh, the new Muppet movie, I was expecting to see, you know, a Muppet movie, a Kermit and Piggy and all of that, you know, wholesome stuff. When I watched this trailer, I was floored. I was like, oh, I just felt like part of my childhood just crushed or something. I didn't know what to think about that. That's why I warned you people not to have anything on there. Not to have any children watching this. This is going to get out and children are going to see this. This is, wow. I mean, it looks funny. It looks comical. but people will find a way to get into the movie. Yeah, and the sad part is, you're going to. It's corruption. It is corruption. I don't even know what to think about it. It's like, oh my goodness, what happened here? But to be honest, I don't know. To be fair, I have to watch. Like I said, I watched Roger Rabbit and I watched parts of Ted. I don't think I've seen the whole Ted movie because it just wasn't doing anything for me. But they went and made a Ted 2, I'm fairly certain. So, again, not a children's movie. But to report on the problem and to get down to the nitty-gritty of it, you actually have to watch some of these things so you can give a good review. Now, just from watching the trailer, I'm telling you, I feel like I need a cigarette after that. No, I feel like something has waylaid the way I thought about the Muppets or any kind of character like that. I don't understand. I don't know this feeling. I need to work through it, I guess. And I think if it was presented to me differently, like when they came back from the movies, it's like, oh, you got to see the new Muppet movie. I was expecting to see what we normally see out of a Muppet movie. No, nothing like that. I was shocked and that's no Muppet I've ever seen before. Okay, although they do resemble some. Like that first one looked like Ratso, but bigger. But, you know, it was like, wow. And it got me to thinking about corruption. It got me to thinking, like, we have hit the downward spiral on that. We are taking things that should be wholesome and making them to filth. And I'm not one to quote anything, but I do believe the story of Sodom and Gomorrah is all about that. It's all about filth. It's horrible. I don't understand. Why do I keep clicking the wrong button? What is that noise? It's just Jim Henson rolling around in his grave. Yeah, I mean, I don't think that he meant for his creations to do that. C is for now. There is. the person who put this, the Cookie Monster, there's a song, and a comedian does it, and C don't stand for cookie in that song. But anyway, yeah, I was disturbed. I think I almost spit stuff out of my mouth. I think I was drinking at the time that I heard that C is for cookie. Yeah, not cookie. That song, I think I was almost spit my drink out when I heard that, because that was wow, oh my god. Yes, it does give Gonzo a new meaning. It was disturbing. But anyway, so it looks funny. It looks adult humorous, but it shouldn't have corrupted that. And I'm wondering, where is it going to stop? Okay? I read another story today that proves this point. And no, let me just go. All right, this is not anything offensive to the Muppets. It is not anything offensive to any community that might fit in this. But apparently, GLAAD calls for LGBT characters in 20% of the movies by 2021. What? Yeah. I don't know about you guys, but when people write a movie, I didn't think that it was like you had to fit certain things in. Now, apparently, you can't have an all-white cast, although you apparently can have an all-black cast and nobody has anything to say about that. But I'm not going to not say. I'm going to say and speak my mind. That's what we do here. I'm not here to offend any particular person. I'm here to offend everybody. But anyway, no, seriously. All right, don't get your briefs in a bunch, people. I'm going to be saying some things that might offend some people. If it does, email me, deal with me, whatever. and insert your the inspiration and careless whispers in the weird spot. Okay, so anyway, I don't know about all of that, but I am going to talk about this, and I posted it on Facebook. I don't know what GLAAD stands for. It's G-L-A-A-D, and it must have something to do with something. But apparently, they are calling for that you have to have certain characters in your show, in your movies, in your stuff. You need to read this story. I don't think it's fair to play this game that they're playing, and it's a dangerous one. But you know what? We're going to get back to that story in a moment. We're going to play Rockin' Robin to ease it up a little bit. Here we go.
Singing his song. All the little birds on Jaybird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet. Rockin' Robin, tweet, tweet, rockin' Robin, tweet, tweet. Blow Rockin' Robin, cause we're really gonna rock up tonight. Every little swallow, every chickadee, every little bird in the tall oak tree. The wise old owl, the big black crow, flap of their wings, singing go bird go. Singing his song. All the little birds on Jaybird Street love to hear the robin go tweet, tweet, tweet. Rockin' Robin, tweet, tweet, rockin' Robin, tweet, 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 tweet.
Commercial again for us, please. If you would. Maybe.
It's the rock concert of the year, and it's coming June 16th. Lamar Dixon Expo Center welcomes the second annual Rock in the Bayou Concert and Car Show, starring Starship. Plus, the voice of Foreigner, Lou Graham. Tickets $30 advance or $45 at the door and going fast at etix.com. You'll also see Matthew and Gunnar Nelson and the world famous Molly Ringwalds. Plus the Artemis Pile Band honoring the music of Ronnie Van Zant's Lynyrd Skynyrd. Also, the Nelson Blanchard Band, Remedy, and more. The second annual Rock in the Bayou Concert and Car Show. Get your tickets now at etix.com. Like us on Facebook, a Scott Ennis production.
Absolutely. That song was Rockin' Robin by Bobby Day. You know, back in the day where stuff wasn't as corrupted and so destructive. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. That's right. We are now covering a story. GLAAD calls for LGBT, so sorry if I get it wrong, I don't even know what it stands for, characters in 20% of movies by 2021. Okay, now, Again, let me preempt this. I am not trying to insult anybody. I am not trying to offend anybody. I'm trying to offend everybody. But anyway, so what gives you the right to force somebody to put stuff in their movies? Hey, if you want to put things in movies, write the damn movie. I'm a movie writer. I'm not going to sit here and say that I'm going to accommodate other people if it don't fit in my movie. Why should I have to put things in a movie that don't fit? Now, you want me to write a movie about something specific? Pay me to write a movie about something specific. I'm not saying, let me be straight. Oh my goodness, a bad name to use. Okay, I'm not trying to say that there's anything wrong with doing whatever your little heart desires. But it does fall into, you know, some of the corruption and whatnot that we were talking about earlier. So, tell me this. Why should I be forced to put things into movies? Oh, thank you. LGBT, lesbian, gay, bi, transgender. Okay. Well, thank you. But why you gotta label everything? Okay. And I think those letters have grown to include other things. I think it's very long. It's pretty much the same length as the alphabet, just saying. But we're all people. Whatever you do in your bedroom is none of my damn business because I ain't in there. If I was in it, then, you know, hey, it's all good. But what happens in my bedroom ain't going to be broadcast all over the place. And what happens in your bedroom should not be broadcast all over the place. Unless, of course, you're making good money off of it. Anyway, stop it. No, sorry. It's, jokes aside. Seriously. I'm writing movies. I'm working on movies. And I don't particularly think, oh, well, let me have to add this character. It's irrelevant to my freaking movie. But somebody told me I had to. Someone who didn't pay me one red cent. Okay, I feel the same way with trying to say, Tyler Perry gets away with it all the time. You can have an all-black cast, but you apparently cannot have an all-white cast. That's against the law. Whatever. Okay, no. If I write a movie and I make a movie, that's going to be the way I made it. It's going to be accommodating to the way I want it. I'm not going to go squeeze in some extra characters just because somebody wants them to. You can't say this. Now, they're wanting to boost it. Let's see. In 2021, they want 20%. By 2024, they want 50% of the characters in movies to have situational issues, or I don't know what you call it. I don't know what you call it. I mean, your thing. I don't want your thing in my movie if I didn't write it to have that in my movie. I'm not saying there's nothing wrong with you doing that. That's your business. But why should I be forced to put it in my movie because it's got to accommodate somebody? No. No. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to continue writing movies the way I write them because that's the way it's going to be. I wrote it. I'm going to get paid to write. You want to pay me to write a movie with your specific request involved? Pay me. Okay? Everything has a price. But I ain't going to put gay, lesbian. And first of all, I thought it was the same thing. But hey, it's all good. You have to put it in separate categories. Go do what you want to do. I'm not going to specifically write a character, gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender, gender fluid, or anything else to accommodate you wanting 50% of the people in the movie to have one of these situations. I don't know what to call it. I don't know what to call it without offending someone. Okay? But what I'm offended that you think you can tell me to write characters into my movie that don't fit in my movie. Okay? Why? Okay? Now, I'm not going to jump on the religious bandwagon and tell you that, you know, yada, yada, yada. Because I'm not going to do that either, because God forbid. But there was a time where my work was my work. So when I write a book or when I do this, it's got to accommodate this. If it don't fit, it don't fit. The movie, I'm not going to have this in my movie. Not because I don't agree with it. Because my character don't fit. Okay? In all the things I've ever written, I don't ever think that I've written specifically for that. Now, there were situationals where, you know, girls might have kissed or guys might have kissed or whatever, but that didn't label them a certain thing. That just made it a character going by what was written in the movie. I mean, I was in a movie. I ain't gonna lie. I was in a movie once. It was about a blow-up doll. No, it's not a sexual movie. It probably could have been, but it wasn't. We didn't go there with it. But I'm going to let y'all try to figure out that movie. I ain't going to give you no more details. But it was a thing. It was something that was required by the script. So you did it because that's what you knew you were getting into when you read the damn script and you accepted the part. You're not going to change it because, oh, well, this, that, and the other. No, this is acting, people. This is what happens. I'm fairly certain I posted that movie on my Facebook page. Just saying. But I'm not going to have somebody telling me that I have to do it because it's not fair for you to tell me that I have to do it. I'm going to write my characters the way I write my characters, and so be it. Whatever they do, they do. I'm not going to label them a certain way. Does other people have to label their characters straight or something like that? No. So why am I going to have to give them a label specifically? And why is 50% of the people in my movie by 2024 gonna have to be under one of these labels, categories, or whatever else? Had to play the commercial out. Okay. We're not gonna have enough time to play everything. Let me see. We're actually gonna. I don't know which is the worst. We're gonna end with Miley Cyrus, and I have to go because to get this in there, ladies and gentlemen, it has been a climb to get to where we are, and it seems like we're falling down off that ledge now. This is the age of corruption apparently, and we need to. Find a way to stop it. All right, so let's listen to Miley Cyrus and The Climb, Child People.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking.